In a country where agriculture accounts for over 70% of employment, its development in all dimensions is key. In the present environment, most farmers have transitioned from traditional to modern ways of farming, including the use of machines and employment of advanced technology at various stages of the production chain. But still, there is more farmers can do to succeed, except this information is never readily available to them.
Farmers across the country lack information. It's difficult for farmers, and I see it every day here, farmers reaching out to us, asking for information. Where do we get this input? How do we manage this crop? How do we deal with this disease? Where are the markets?
The NADS CEO, Dr. Samuel Mugasa, explains why in their pursuit to bridge the gap between farmers and accessing information, they opted to collaborate with Vision Group through the platform provided during the Harvest Money Expo.
One of the key areas of our focus is bringing information to the farmers, supporting them with inputs for specific value chains, supporting also in validation, agro-processing, and marketing. So we have a footstep, a footprint across the entire value chain. So indeed, as we come to the expo, the Farmers Expo, we are sponsors, we are proud to be sponsors of this expo, and I think we are gold sponsors, and we have been sponsoring this expo for quite a number of years, and we are proud to be part of this expo because it's a platform for us to reach out to the farmers.
Noting concerns that agriculture as a sector grows with varying climatic and other competing factors, Dr. Mugasa urged farmers across the country to be objective and put more emphasis on harnessing diversification of the country's agriculture export base.
We are now talking about high value crops. We are now talking about diversifying our agricultural export base. You know, traditionally Uganda has been focusing on coffee and tea. Previously, we had tobacco and cotton. These are no longer on the market. So districts or farmers who used to grow, for example, cotton and are no longer growing it, we are now encouraging them to go into cashew nuts and macadamia. Areas that used to grow tobacco and are no longer growing tobacco, we are now giving an alternative to them. They can grow Hass avocado, they can grow macadamia.
As partially highlighted in this year's theme, post-harvest handling will be top on the Harvest Money Expo agenda.
Hass avocado is a perishable crop, and therefore we must plan ahead of time for post-harvest handling. The good news for now is that we have factories. We have one factory in Namanje, one in Mabira, the third one in Kapeka, the fourth one in Chenjojo, actually there are five. Fourth one in Chenjojo and the fifth in Kasese. These are factories that are adding value to fresh avocado for oil extraction.
He tipped on modern ways of farming, focused on climate-smart agriculture that does not affect the environment, and urged farmers to come to the expo to acquire more agriculture knowledge. Entrance is going to be 10,000 shillings and training per day also 10,000 shillings. Derek Asaba reporting for the news.